Hi, I'm Heather at the Kraaft Shaak, where we believe all were created by the Creator to be creative. Join me now for another art adventure.
Hello, and welcome to Heather's Art Adventure. Today we are using two supplies, just two. We're using the Polychromos from Faber-Castell colored pencils. And we are using Canson XL black drawing paper. That's it. Now, the beginning of this is a little bit hairy because it was a live stream and there was some internet issues that took place, but trust me, it'll clear up any second now. It will, I promise. It was a very interesting project because I wanted to do this beautiful white peony that I had taken a picture of at a friend's house in Tennessee when we had visited during the southern tour of the Kraaft Shaak. And it's just this big, beautiful bloom. I mean, I can't even describe it, but it was as big as my head. So I took tons and tons of pictures, and the way the light was casting on it and everything, I knew I wanted to do something with this. And I've done a couple of pieces using this particular image as a reference. This one was just to be a study to start with. I had no intention of it being anything. I wanted to see if with one pencil, could I do an entire drawing on black paper, because I had never done anything like this before, so I wasn't totally sure how it would work. And using the reference, at first I was trying to really copy it, and then, as usually happens to me, I kind of get lost in the details and forget that I have a reference. But every once in a while I go back to the reference, and I'll bring that back up on screen every now and then during this video so you can see it as well. One of the things that I struggled with was, how do I put in shades of white using a using just a colored pencil? How do I do that? And so in my attempts or my study of this throughout this process, it was an entire learning process. And as I was learning as I went, by the end, I felt like I was very confident with the pencil. In the very beginning, it's like, okay, I know I need the outline, I know I need this, but where am I going to put shading? And I started going around kind of the petals like you normally would when you're putting in shading, and I realized the white is kind of the highlight, not like usually use your pencil to shade, and this is going to be like the paper needs to be the shade. So it was kind of this weird backwards kind of, I'm not sure if I'm doing this right type of deal. So you see me kind of bounce around a little bit, because that's when you know that I'm like, I don't know, that doesn't seem right, just come back to it. And that sort of thing. So I did speed this video up 2.5 times. It was a live stream, as we usually do. Our art adventures are live streams over on Twitch. And then new in 2021, I am making a concerted effort to grab those videos and turn them into what you're watching now, a streamlined, sped up, much shorter version. And hopefully this is what you are wanting, is more of these types of videos. I'd love it if you'd leave a comment letting me know if you prefer voiceover or just music. Obviously, if you're somebody who listens to these, you know, watches these videos on mute or with no sound, then you're not hearing me say that. So So part of the fun for live streaming is the conversation that takes place. And there was a lot of conversation about this day and the trip, the southern tour trip that we took. Mr. Crafter, T-Dog, and I got to pretend for a week that we were on our, I can't remember what the heck you call it. Like, this was like our job, that we got to go and do our art concerts. And at the Hensley Manor, we were able to not just do an art concert, but be treated like royalty. They're the most wonderful hosts. It was just wonderful. We were really blessed the whole trip because we had fantastic friends who let us stay, let us park out front, let us and took us to breakfast. I mean, all kinds of things. So it was just really a wonderful time to get to meet some online friends in person and really learn just how hospitable they really are. It's not just words on, in a video. They're actually wonderful people in person. And so when this thing was all done and I looked at this piece, I was very happy with it and decided it wasn't just a study, it was a gift, and sent it on to the owners of that big, beautiful peony that they let me take a picture of and let us stay in their home and let us do an art concert and supported us so very well. So I thought, I hope it was a good gift. I hope it was something they enjoy. So again, as I was stating before, you notice now that I'm creating kind of a shadow by missing some of the black paper. Like, I'm creating sort of a black outline by only putting the pencil down with that outline around. And so I had kind of figured out, oh, okay, I gotta leave paper as my darkest shadow. That black paper has to be the darkest shadow. So as we go, it'll be lighter pressure for some of the shading, and then, you know, you press a little bit harder to get some of that crisper white out of it, and that sort of gives the illusion that it's twisting and turning, and that, like, the bottom petal that's underneath my hand there to the right, it looks more like it's sticking out towards us, and the back portion is away from us because of the shadowing and the shading of that those pencil lines. And that's kind of what I'm trying to achieve, all with one pencil. This is, the entire time it's just one pencil on a black pad of paper. So now you see me take my hand off the paper and come away for a bit. Usually I am either dealing with the comments for the live stream, which is why I'll cut all that out during this video, but also to sharpen the pencil, because if you look at the point, it's getting duller and duller and duller. And when you are trying to get into some of these more precise areas, you don't want that big thick line that comes from a duller point. You want more of a precise thin line. And so that will require a pencil sharpener to do that. And I use the Prismacolor handheld manual sharpener for Prismacolor pencils. And I have found that's the best pencil sharpener I've ever had. I would like to have an electric one that does as well, but you know, your colored pencils, if you start to invest in colored pencils, you realize just how expensive they are, and the last thing you want is a machine chewing it all up. So even if I found a good one, I probably wouldn't use it for these because I'd be afraid I'd lose half of my pencil doing that. So yeah, the manual pencil works just, or pencil sharpener works just fine, and I really enjoy using colored pencils. I need to do it more. There's the Prismacolor sharpener I was talking about. And yeah, you need a sharper. See how thin that line is when it's sharp like that? Prismacolor, That's not what I meant to say. Polychromos is what I'm using. The Polychromos by Faber-Castell are by far my favorite colored pencil. I have 4 different colored pencils. I think actually I gave away my Prismacolor, so I have 3 different colored pencils. The Polychromos are my favorite because they're wax-based, but the pigment that they put down is intense. It's a very intense, and it's like so low effort to put that color down. I mean, even look at how I'm just adjusting that and adding petals into that already drawn area, and it just, it's a breeze. There's no push really, really hard. I don't have to make dents in the paper in order for the color to come down. It's just a really great pencil to use. It feels wonderful to use these pencils. If you've ever used, like, you know, a cheap grade school version, like Crayola colored pencils, you know, you can color with them, they're fine, but then when you go to add detail and layers and things, you'll notice that you have to really work at it to make it work. And so maybe you upgrade to like a Prismacolor, which those are a good pencil as well, and you know, you upgrade to that, and then you notice that, again, you're doing more detailed work, and you're trying to get those fine lines and that blending and everything, and it's not quite working after a few layers, and you really have to push hard to make it happen or to get enough vibrant color out of them. And that was kind of where I was at. This has been the progression of my colored pencil art adventure, is just finding that, you know, that doesn't quite do what I want it to do now that I've progressed in my drawing or whatever. And so these Polychromos were kind of like, I tried them out in a store, and they've been on my list for a long, long time. And then one year for Christmas, the year that I did this drawing, I got them for Christmas as a major surprise from Mr. Crafter, which was so awesome, because they're not cheap. They come in a big metal tin, and I got the full set, which I've never had the full set of anything at that point. So it's like, holy cow, what an extravagant gift. And I have tried my best to use them to their fullest potential as a thank you for such a gift. And it's funny, I get gifts like that every once in a while, and I have a couple of wonderful benefactors who do make sure that I get good quality art supplies over the years. And the greatest gift I can give, they have all said to me, is to use them. And so that's what I try to do. And now that I'm watching this video, I realize I need to use these a little bit more too. So so now you see, as I'm putting in these back petals on the left side, they have more of a shadow to them. And so I'm very lightly sketching in the shadowed line, and then very lightly I'm putting in that shaded petal, because they're really more in a darker area. And, you know, for that portion of the drawing, I really am looking at the reference photo to get an idea of where I would cast shadows and how far on the petal the blackness would go. And I'm actually I'm leaving a lot more black than the reference is telling me to, because I can go in and shade more. Like I can keep adding layers and bringing it down further and all that, and slowly building up the white color of the flower, but it's very hard to take it away. I mean, I don't want to erase any of this, because it's white wax crayon basically on top of a black paper. So rather than worrying about erasing, I'm just adding a little bit at a time until the look seems natural and achievable. And that's where not looking at the reference takes place. So I look at the reference to see what I need to do to accomplish, but then I look at what my drawing is and what I have put on the paper to have it make sense. So you'll see that as we go through this process here, where I'm putting in these back petals, I'm trying to make sure that it looks full and has lots and lots of petals that have bloomed out and are curling and pulling away from the center, and maybe even turning towards the back, because this is a late bloom peony. This is on its last days, and those petals have been around for a while. Those big ones are open and curling, and some of the edges are a little bit worn. And you'll notice in that petal up there at the very top, I have a very different shadowing taking place than what is in this reference photo, because the petals that I put down don't look the same as the petals that are in the reference photo in front of it casting that shadow. So it makes sense that my shadows would be a little bit different. So it's pay attention to the reference photo, but it doesn't have to be perfect. That's what I use reference photos for, is to learn where to put things. So this is it. This turned out pretty well, I think, and I'm very happy with it. I hope that you've enjoyed watching, and that you'll let me know if you like hearing this voiceover, or if you'd prefer music instead. I don't mind. We are going to put a couple of frames around this thing to get a look, because I was really impressed with it when I was done and thought, you know what, this needs to go as a gift to my friend Bobby and Sheila. They need to see this. So I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for joining me for the Tennessee White Peony, and I hope you'll have a very crafty day.